Hello everyone.
I showed a template example and explained the duties of files. On this part, I'll show how to download toolchain, ESP IDF, and how to set up the environment to compile the project.
Let's start the machine.
As I mentioned before, we need to set up toolchain to compile our projects. So, let's look at programming guide of Espressif. This guide is very useful to learn anything about ESP IDF. I'll start it from Get Started menu. It gives us information about ESP32 and what we need. We can also check hardware of our development board from here. We will apply these steps that are listed. For step 1, we need to choose the proper version for operating system of our computer. I use Windows, so I'll choose it. You can apply this step for Linux or macOS from there. The other steps will be same as Windows. There's a download link for toolchain and MSYS2 environment. It's so useful because we don't need to download two of them separately. After downloading it, let's unzip it to see disk of our computer. Then open the MSYS32 file and open this application. The ESP IDF build system only supports MinGV32 mode. Don't try it with 64 mode. Let's create a folder called ESP thanks to commands. And go inside of it with commands. Then we should download ESP IDF from GitHub. To make it without going to browser again, let's use git commands and enter it. This is which version we would like to download, and this command get the submodules of ESP IDF. And don't forget it, I'll write this commands on description. Let's download it. This will take some time. After getting ESP IDF, let's go to the add to path cd /etc/profile.d. We will use vim command to create a file, vim export idf path.sh. To write something inside it, press I and wrote this. I wrote it there because it's my username of the computer. You can check it from there if you forgot it. After writing it, press escape button and wrote double dot WQ with lowercase and press enter. Now, let's close the terminal and open it again. We can check IDF path like that. So we did it successfully. If you didn't get a response like this, you probably could miss something at last step. We can also check it and change it from File Explorer. Go to etc and profile.h and check export IDF path file. If you couldn't get it from terminal, copy paste a .sh file, rename it as export IDF path, then write export IDF path and reopen terminal. After managing IDF path, let's try the template file that I explained last video. Create a file for our examples. Then, let's clone the template project. Then open the file and wrote make menu config. It's a system that we will determine flash features at here. You can check it each time if you would like to explore it. I'll explain some of them. If you don't have ESP32 board yet, you can leave menu config as defaults for now. Go to serial flasher config and choose which serial port we will use. If you don't know it, you can check it from device manager. This is our part. And increase flashing baud rate to flash faster. Choose flash size of your board. If you don't know it, check datasheet from your supplier. But most of the ESP32 boards have 4 MB flash size. If we look at example configuration, as you can see, there is a config that we can change. I explained it last video if you remember. It comes from kconfig file. We can also add another menus to menuconfig or add another configuration to example configuration tab. Then exit from menu config, save, wait the process. Then we're ready to flash our project to our board. If you don't have board and only try ESP IDF, wrote only make and enter. If you have it, we can write make flash monitor and enter. Make command will compile our project. Flash will be flashed it to our board. And monitor will open the communication after flashing. It will take some time at first compiling a project. Then we got it successfully. It compiled and flashed to board successfully. As we can see, it writes hello world to console each 5 minutes. If you have downloaded specific version that I've used, you probably don't got any error. There are some error types you could get. I'll explain it to you. If you got an error like Python not satisfied, probably you didn't download the right toolchain and ESP version. Install required tools with Pacman. Or if you don't want to struggle it, delete everything you installed and start with first step. Install toolchain and ESP with same version. If you got error like that, you couldn't add IDF path successfully. Go to this step and apply it again. If you got error like that, you choose wrong serial port or couldn't change it from menu config. Fix it and try again. If you got error like that, you should upgrade your port driver. Or you can deal it with pressing reset and boot button on the board when you see connecting line. Finally, we learn how to create an environment for ESP IDF and some error types with how to fix it. On the next video, I'll show FreeRTOS library for ESP IDF. That's all I am going to talk about today. Stay motivated and subscribe me. Let's control the controllers together.